Day 49 of the lockdown, aka never ending story. Shouts out to the Flu Manchu. I forgot kind of yesterday to really get into, we're in May. We're in freaking May. And I saw all the memes. It's gonna be May. let me ask some, was it me or did March went really slow, but April flew. It went so fast. I just think everybody got in a routine. And now we see some states are slowly starting to open up, which is going to create another uproar in the news. Should we open up states? Should we open up states? Should or shouldn't we? And I'll tell you a couple things is that I noticed in May. Is Kim Jong-un from North Korea, is he alive or isn't he dead? Is he dead or is he alive? I don't know. Like, what is it? I think we'll never know. It's literally going to be like Weekend of Bernie's. Sports still, I mean, are they coming back? Will they come back? So far, football season, basketball. I said in a post and on Twitter, I don't care where sports is played. I don't care if baseball's on a softball field, if basketball's at the YMCA, if NFL football's on a high school field. I don't care. I don't care if fans are there. I just want some sports again. Now, one thing I am kind of excited about, I have not been on a plane since the middle of March, which is a new record for me in the last 20 years. When I do go back on a plane, it's going to be interesting. Because the rules have changed. It's all American, said you got to wear a mask. My thing is, like, the airlines, I hope they're providing masks. Because that would be the worst. If you buy a ticket and then you get to the airport. Oh, I forgot my mask, or I don't have a mask, and you can't get on the plane. So hopefully they'll provide you with masks and sanitary. I used to always wipe down my tray anyways. I always brought disinfectant wipes and wipe down everything. And I always got hand sanitizer in my bag. I was doing that for the last 6 months, regardless. And, but one thing with the mask and when we're flying, are we able to eat? Has anybody flown? Can help me out? Are you able to eat? Or do you got to eat underneath the mask? Or we got to eat? Do we got to do straws now? You know, protein drinks. And then one good thing though, I don't think people are going to be talking to neighbors anymore, which I'm not antisocial, but on the plane, the worst job to be on a plane and start up a conversation is to be a comedian. Because if you're a comedian and somebody sits down next to you and start up a conversation and you say you're a comedian, you only get a couple responses. Tell me a joke. Nope, I'm off work. I'm not telling you a joke. Or they're going to tell you a joke, which you don't want to hear. So now you got to look at them, give them a fake laugh. Don't want to do that. Or they ask you, do you know a comedian? Those are the three responses you get. I'm just saying, from a comedian, somebody sits down next to you, that's the only three you get. They either tell you a joke, they want to hear a joke, or they ask you, do you know this comedian? That's it. And then the worst is if they don't know you and they ask you, what have you been in? So now you got to give off your credits. And if you've been in something big and they don't realize it's you, it's the worst. Cause then sometimes people just, they talk so loud and you're trying to be quiet. Now people start to look. And then when you land, you don't realize how quiet the plane is. And then you talk once you land, cause the engines are shutting off. And then someone be like, I'm gonna look for you, man. Or it was nice meeting you, man. Can I get a picture or autograph for my kid? Keep in mind, they didn't know who I was when they got on a plane, but now they want a picture autograph. That's cool. It comes with it, but oh, now that these masks are here, ain't nobody talking. Ain't nobody gonna know nothing. So that's the one good thing. So I ain't gotta hear no more bad jokes. So that's the plus. Because that's the work. Because listen, if you're not a comedian and you tell a comedian a joke, just make sure it's under 30 seconds. There ain't nothing worse. And then 90% of the time people are telling you a stock joke. You're like, yeah, I've heard it. I've read that. Same joke. Or that, you know, or there's, or the punchline is so bad. And you just got to look at them. And then they look at you like, this is the best. You can use that if you want to. Thanks. Because I'm struggling right now. So, all right. Well, guess what? Tomorrow's day 50. This is crazy. This is crazy now. If I'm still doing these lockdown videos and I'm on day 320, shit has officially hit the fan. If we get to triple digits, if I get to day 100, shit's hit the fan. All right, y'all. We'll see you tomorrow. I think I'm going to have my wife on tomorrow. Why not? Everybody's asking if my wife and kids are still alive. Problem is they got to get ready to get on video. They got to put makeup on and I don't look right. I don't want people talking about me. So that's why I haven't shown them too much. It's just been me and my dog, basically. I ain't got to get the dog ready. Me and her, we were all dogged. I come in red cheeks and everything is what it is. All right, y'all. We'll see you tomorrow. Day 50.